An interesting question is, why are there so many plastic bags? Why are plastic bags so freely available? Why are they apparently so cheap?
We consume approximately 10 billion plastic bags a year. That is just supermarket only. So when you then start taking in account corner shops and clothing bags, you know, all the other shops, we throw away about 100,000 tons of plastic bags a year.
I mean, I've never really liked plastic bags, they're really ugly things. But I really noticed it when we went to India, and we went for a walk along the beach, and the beach was completely strewn with plastic bags, just everywhere, and it was just awful. We live in this really kind of protected country where all our rubbish is just picked up and carried away. They're living and experiencing at a very close hand way the sorts of things that that are spirited away for us. The same thing's happening here, but we don't see it.
We pay our tax to local authority, and for that we expect, you know, that the streets are clean of crime and clean of grime. It's their responsibility when we put the rubbish out that they deal with it. And that process, that exchange of money for their responsibility, robs people of the deep understanding, the consequences of doing that.
When you take a plastic bag and throw it away, they don't actually break down into anything which can merge with the earth and become part of the earth's life cycle. So they just break down into these sort of tiny particles of plastic and actually pollute the lives of organisms in the earth.
They get into the waterways, they get into the land, they get into the fish. Animals eat them, everybody's ingesting. We probably all got little bits of plastic bags in our stomachs. And the idea that we are eating plastic bags, I mean, surely that would put people off.
Plastic generally, but plastic bags particularly, are destroying the natural. Humans are one of millions of species. There are 100 million species around the world, upon this planet, and human beings are one of them. We must not think that the world is made for human use. We have this view that everything is lifeless matter which can be used for human beings. But Earth is not a lifeless matter. Trees, plants, animals, they are all living beings. Plastic is taking over. Therefore, we need to develop a new world view.
One of the most interesting of all applications of this new film is in packaging. The final product will not dry out and become brittle with age. Production controls ensure exceptional and consistent quality. More and more, the properties of this film are bringing new ideas to industry and the home, to manufacturing and distribution. And with them are coming new and better things for us all.
We have the raw material delivered in the form of polythene polymer, which looks like grains of rice. 25 tons of polythene polymer, which will convert into 25 tons of bags. You know, it's no change chemically, it's just a change in the shape of the material. You take the beads or grains of polymer, heat it up and change its shape. That's all you do.
Plastic is a byproduct of creating fuel. We have a massive oil industry, which is basically there to provide fuel for our cars and engines and factories. So there's tons of plastic there. And if the oil producing industries can make a bit of extra money on this byproduct, they will. So they make plastic bags in vast numbers, billions of them, and provide them to supermarkets. And supermarkets having lots of people walking around with your logo on their plastic bag is a brilliant way to get advertising.
We go to supermarkets sometimes twice a day. We go to supermarket at lunchtime, we'll get a bag. Then we go on the way home, we get another bag, maybe two or three.
Supermarkets, plastic bag, flying around in the air. I'm living life free, but not without cost. I'm cheap and I'm lost.
I think the supermarkets are convinced that they need to change. And I think consumers in some areas in the UK are convinced that that change will happen.
Much better. Over and over and over and over.
I think that we're going to have a tax on plastic bags. I think the supermarkets have been pre-warned, and that's why they're starting to introduce these biodegradable plastic bags.
These are bags which have an additive incorporated as you extrude the film, which causes the bag to decay in a landfill site into moisture, water, carbon dioxide, and this vague biomass, not very much biomass.
There are some supermarkets realizing that people are demanding environmental sustainability.
This is a biodegradable refuse sack in our eco-friendly range.
What is the way forward? Degradable plastic bags, biodegradable plastic bags, bags for life, reusable bags.
So far, it's probably 0.001%. If it goes well, I think we might sell 5%. But there are disadvantages about these bags. You can't store them too long.
They're still being made in factories. They're still being trucked around. They're still very energy inefficient.
Biodegradable bags are still plastic bags, and they are made of oil. I think supermarkets are just doing a greenwash and just sort of camouflaging themselves to show they are green, but it is not green. They give you illusion that you are saving the planet by using biodegradable bags.
The solution is to do what very aware countries like New Zealand and Australia are doing, which is just using hemp or organic cotton or alternatives. And we as consumers need to keep remembering to bring those bags with us and just make it as part of our day life.
When more and more people stand up for the rights of nature and against pollution and global warming and for natural products, then more and more people will become aware of it. And they will put pressure on the legislative assemblies and the parliaments to bring legislation.
I think somebody said that the plastic bag is almost a national emblem at this stage. It flutters from trees, from hedges, from wires and everything else. So we decided that we'd try and cut down on the use of plastic bags, and from that emerged the idea of a levy.
I think what they've done in the Republic of Ireland is amazing. And I have been in favour of measures to get rid of plastic bags for more than 30 years. So I'd like to see the whole of the UK government follow suit in Northern Ireland, Scotland, Wales.
I just don't see the need for plastic bags. They're not relevant and they're not appropriate. And I just think it's the responsibility of the British public to take it upon themselves to say no to plastic bag. Hence the name, One Less Plastic Bag. They're just so lovely. There's all sorts of different bags, you know, different colours, different styles. They're made from reclaimed sari. You know, they're so beautiful. And they are strong and they're machine washable. In fact, I will demonstrate with this one. Various different, you can see how strong they are. And also how much capacity they have. You know, look, they're just so strong. And you can fold it nicely or you can just chuck it in, which is what I do most of the time. And there you have it, this really beautiful little bag, which you just pop in your handbag. You buy something, you say to the man, you say, I've got a bag, thanks. So while you're getting your bag out, he's got a plastic bag out and he's starting to put your stuff into the plastic bag. And you're like, no, I've got a bag, thanks. And you carry on. And more often than not, they're not listening. So they hand you this bag, this plastic bag full of your stuff. It might be a bit embarrassing, but what you have to do is take the stuff out of the plastic bag that he's given you and put it into your bag so that you can go off with your bag, and that's one less plastic bag, you see. It's brilliant, I love it.
I feel like a supermarket plastic bag flying around in the air. I'm living life free, but not without cost. I'm cheap and I'm lost. A supermarket plastic bag swirling and twirling around. There's no one in view. The signpost I knew points up to the sky.